Let's review how the transparent bridge learns. As we've learned, a transparent bridge is truly plug and play. All that's required is for it to be connected into the network, plugged in, and turned on. The bridge does the rest. After a while, the transparent bridge contains a list of all device addresses and on what port they were received. This information is used for forwarding packets with the matching destination addresses out specific ports, which reduces overall network traffic. The addresses remain in the table for a specified period of time, normally 5 minutes. If not refreshed within that period, the address and port reference are discarded. Devices that move are updated in the source address table as soon as they generate traffic from the new location. Device addresses and locations can be permanently configured in the source address table if the network manager so decides. This might be useful for devices that do not generate traffic but only need to receive data. Some old printers and plotters operate this way. Bridges can support all LAN protocols. However, each bridge has different capabilities. Some only support a single protocol and bandwidth, while others support a multitude of capabilities. The transparent bridge is used in 95% of all bridging environments. The other type of bridging, source route bridging, is far less common. It's only found in token ring networks, and in fact, even though source route bridging was developed for token ring, most token ring networks today have migrated to transparent bridging.